Welcome to Jodhpur.
Beautiful murals all the way up either side.
Super excited here, like a little kid.
We can do this. I'm shaking though.
Abby's stuck. Hello everybody and welcome to Jodhpur, also known as the Blue City.
As you can see, it's literally putting the pink city to shame. The walls are actually genuinely bright blue.
Yeah. We thought, where better place to start than in the old city walls just opposite the fort, where the buildings are blue.
So this area definitely feels a lot more residential than other areas. We've not seen many tourists walking around, which is very nice because we're seeing people just go about their daily lives at the moment. It's absolutely stunning with the blue walls. We've got murals everywhere. We've got like bunting on the roof.
Oh, hello.
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 What is your name?
Just people casually walking their donkeys down the road. See something new every day in India, without a doubt.
You can see where the murals were, but unfortunately it's been rubbed off from the sandstone, which is a shame because I reckon it would have been really beautiful, all covered.
I mean, they are still.
Yeah, you can still see remnants of it, just rubbed off at the bottom from the tuk-tuk drivers, I guess.
Yeah, this is called the paint wall, apparently.
Ah, beautiful.
Could do with a repainting, and then.
So this is the blue corridor.
Hello.
Hello. Temple's ready?
Yeah, we're looking around.
This is your temple.
Thank you.
Your blue house.
Okay.
Blue house.
Thank you.
Cool.
Thank you.
Hey,
want
to
have a
guide?
No, thank you. So this is the famous blue corridor, and you can see why, because they've got beautiful murals all the way up either side in the colour blue.
Why do you keep calling everything murals? What's the difference between a mural and a painting?
It's the same thing, but a mural is a larger version, isn't it?
I don't know.
On a wall. It's on a wall as well, I think. But anyway, regardless, we've got all these cool street art. Kind of tells a story as well, doesn't it?
Yeah, it's cool.
And if you want a guide, that little lad was doing tours.
Yeah, bless
him. So go and see him.
Yeah, you can see him trying.
Yeah,
I knew what was happening.
We've kind of been walking around for about an hour already now, haven't we?
Yeah, yeah.
I've seen loads of pictures of these blue steps as well, and hopefully Abby's getting a cool edgy shot of me walking up. I've got the mural, little donkey. Hello, namaste.
After an hour of soaking up the culture and getting a real feel for the city, it was time to try a very popular drink here in Jodhpur.
So Jodhpur is really famous for Makhaniya Lassi, and I've not tried one yet. And this place behind us, which is the Mishrila Hotel, is apparently one of the best places to get it, and it's just outside our next center destination.
Can you get one of the lassi? How do you get Makhaniya?
Yeah.
Is that how you say it?
Makhaniya.
I get one of them.
Yeah, inside. Or do you want to sit outside?
Outside.
Inside or outside? Inside?
Inside.
Inside. Okay. We'll just sit here.
Thank you. Right, me trying my first lassi here in India.
It means the very nice Jodhpur lassi.
Jeez. Tastes like lemon sherbet. Tastes like lemon cheesecake. I wasn't expecting that. I was expecting to sip it. But you eat it like an
like
ice cream. No, it tastes really... You'll really like that, Gaz. It's really zingy. Flavours are so sweet. So we've got the clock tower right here, which is apparently still working to this day, and it's very, very old. And then we've got the fort right in our background, which we will be checking out tomorrow. So that's exciting. It's got a beautiful skyline if you want to get some good pictures.
Yeah, the fort in Jodhpur like overhangs the whole of the city, and it looks absolutely epic, doesn't it?
Yeah.
I want to go and check out this clock tower. I've just dribbled. This clock tower, as it's literally on like every guide you see, like every attraction poster people are trying to take you there. But I'm wondering if you can actually go up it.
Look at this guy in the background.
Or if we just have to... oh God, bloody hell, his back must be hurting. or if it's just to look at it. Entry free. 10 p.m. to 6, right, let's have a look. Okay, so I stand corrected. It costs 100 to go up to the clock tower.
For the selfie point.
You want to go up and take a selfie?
So this first floor is literally it. You can't go all the way up to the top because if you go look at a bell, then you have to tip the guy to open the bell up, but we're not bothered about that. At least you get some form of okay
views.
Unless
you want a picture with a bell end. Oh wait, you've got one here. Look at this. I am actually super excited here like a little kid as we're now at our first step well in India, which is in the heart of Jodhpur. Abby's like, what the hell is a step well? Well, Abby, it steps down to a well and it looks epic. And a quick history lesson for you here, guys. I know you like them, but the step wells in India are traditionally built by the ladies of the royal households or the royal families, etc. So yeah, this was built, I think, in 1740, would you believe it? God, people are feeding the fish. Whoa, look how many fish.
So many fish.
Yeah.
There's literally so
Abby, you're interrupting the history lesson that people want to know about.
Oh, yeah.
But yeah, very old here, but very beautiful.
The long row of bread from the top.
All the way down.
Phew.
So we've headed to the Stepwell Cafe for some lunch and some good views. It's almost a hip and trendy cafe in India, which you do find actually.
Oh, it's got the
You'd be surprised. Since I've had a bad stomach, I have no idea what to eat.
Having a nice refreshment break overlooking the pretty epic views.
Okay, we're up bright and early this morning, guys, because we are going to not walk around the famous fort here in Jodhpur. We are about to go a zip lining around it.
Yeah, this is one of the things that we have been the most excited to do of this leg of the trip, potentially in India. So we're super stoked. And also we get free access to the fort as well, which is quite cool.
Yeah, I'm really nervous, but I'm feeling a lot better today. So yeah, it's gonna be good. There's 6 zip lines in total, so it's gonna be action packed.
In case you're wondering why we're not saying the name of the fort, it's because we can't pronounce it.
Yeah, I'll put it on the screen.
Yeah, it's like a maze, isn't it?
Pretty nervous because I was saying, like, normally when you do a zip line, it's like one zip line and then like the adrenaline rush is over because you're done. But there's 6, so you have to keep going for every adrenaline rush to get put back on and then go again. Oh god, it's okay. And I've been ill, so my brain's still foggy. But it's good. We could do this. We could do this.
Oh, emergency. Oh, no emergency.
So with great difficulty, we've just got the guide to tell us the name of the fort, which is Mehrangarh Fort. I'm probably still butchering it. But yeah, this fort's absolutely stunning and it's like carved out of the red cliffs on the side of the wall looking over the city. So yeah, it's a vibe.
It's getting strapped up.
A little bit of information for you here. Tickets cost 1,700 rupees, which is about $20 per person. And there's only 3 of us on a tour, so we've opted for the 9:30 a.m. tour to get those early morning views of the city. But yeah, excited, strapped up, ready to go.
Who wants to go first?
First one, here we go. Oh God, yeah, this is quite a...
I'm out of breath, I'm nervous.
Ready, sir?
Yeah, let's go.
Ready, go. Woo-hoo-hoo! Break.
I was so scared I forgot to break.
Oh, that was fun though, wasn't it?
That was really fun. That was so fun. Oh. I'm shaking though. And we got five more to go, is it?
I'm nervous. Shaking stuff.
That was fun though, wasn't it?
Is this the second one?
This is the last one. And this come back here.
Oh, this is the last one. Ah. Ah, cool. Ah, nice. Look, so we go all around it. You can see the blue city as well. So cool.
There's also, one of the things to do here is the geological rock park, which we're ziplining around as well. So
Oh, really? We're
knocking off all of the top things to do via the zipline. The third one's got bloody epic views of the fort. Yeah, this is top quality so far. And there's another step well there.
Abby, step well. Oh, neglecting my duties.
So we're heading to the last zip line, which is 310 meters, which is the best and the longest one. So that's exciting.
It says it's the best one because you have the city view and
the fort
as well.
We can sit and picnic here.
Wow. Is there crocodiles in that water?
No, ma'am.
you wanted there to be a yes there, didn't you?
Yeah.
To add suspense.
Yeah, what were you hoping for?
I thought I saw something swimming.
Ah,
Bob. A bird? Oh! don't try this at home.
No.
How are you feeling about the last one?
Nervous.
Excited though.
Okay.
Yeah.
This is fun, isn't it?
Yeah, my hands are really sweating. Good
fun.
Yeah.
I'm sweating from adrenaline.
It's like 9 a.m. and it's, yeah, we're just going
to
zip.
Ready,
man? Yeah.
Go.
She's stuck?
Yeah. Because it was windy.
Oh, but from the wind?
Yeah.
Needs to pull herself up, yeah. Ah.
So Abby's stuck right just a few metres from the end, so she's going to have to drag herself up. I can still hear her screaming. Oh. Oh, God. I don't know if you can see.
I don't know if you saw, but I got stuck, so I didn't go as fast as I could. So I stuck halfway across the second lake and then had to like pull myself around and back to get across the line. So now my arms are aching, but it was very scary. Oh gosh. But I'm surprised at myself because normally I would have like freaked out hardcore at that point and just completely probably passed out and hoped someone would save me, but I saved myself for a change. Woo, adrenaline rush now. God.
Bats. Up here. Bats. Oh yes, of course. I was wondering where they were.
So
I thought I could smell. You know when you can smell like a bat.
Oh my God, they're really close. That's
the only flying mammals.
Oh my God, there's so many.
Yeah, I thought it smelled like a
cake.
That's why.
Bats. Oh, it does smell like bats, actually, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Well, that was the end of our Jodhpur adventure. Probably one of the highlights of our trip so far, as we absolutely love an adrenaline activity. This city was so fun to explore and just roam around the beautiful streets. If you enjoyed this video, then make sure you give us a thumbs up, hit the subscribe button, and we'll see you in the next one. Bye!